Happy 200th anniversary of Pride and Prejudice. So I'm kind of a lit nerd, secretly. But I wanted to make today's video blog a little special because today is Momentous Day. I've compiled a small list of things that you should do today to celebrate the momentous occasion. One of them would be, of course, owning up to your adoration of the books, the original book. Another thing would be to definitely check out the live readathon on the Jane Austen Center's website. They started at 11 their time and they're ending 11 their time. So if you have a second and you watch this, check it out. And I think that they said that they're going to be posting little links to it later, little snippets. So when they post that, check it out because it's a pretty cool live readathon of Pride and Prejudice. On that note, so that's the first thing you should do. Check out the readathon. Second thing is check out the Lizzie Bennet Diaries because I think that modern adaptations just show that things are still relevant in some ways. I know that some people criticize Jane Austen for the romance and the unrealistic aspects of that, but I think that a lot of us like her for her wit and the way she criticizes society. So whatever you like her for, I think that she's still relevant if we're still making adaptations of her books into films. And the Lizzie Bennet Diaries is a really great adaptation on a different level, like using new media to express the series. I like how they use Twitter and other forms of social media to tell the story. And so we're just going to see how that continuously gets redefined, that story gets continuously redefined through the ages. So watch any adaptation you can get your hands on. If you've never been to Bath, you should definitely take a trip to Bath because it's really the epitome of Jane Austen's novels. I mean, the Jane Austen Center is there and they have a great little thing that you get to walk through and you get to see little like fake shop fronts and you get to see costumes and little exhibits on different aspects of the Regency era in Jane Austen's novels. And there's a little dress-up area in the back which I adored. Putting on a bonnet, who would have thought that could be so much fun? But it is. And then you get to walk around Bath, and it feels like you're walking through an Austen novel. Just being able to do the walking tour where someone gets to tell you where all these amazing things happened in Jane Austen's life, or the few things in the novels, or where movies have been filmed, it's pretty cool because you feel like you're walking through these books that you've read, and I don't know, it's kind of eerie but amazing at the same time. So definitely plan your trip to Bath, even if it's not in the next year, in the next 5 years sometime, because it's really fun, and they have a lot of goodies in the gift shop. I am guilty of buying things online a lot from their shop when they have amazing deals. So if you can't go to Bath, if you can't do any of these things today, I highly suggest doing the following, which I'm doing tonight. Making yourself some tea, making yourself a lovely batch of scones, unless you say scones, then you can say scones as well, and watching the epitome of adaptations, right?